Philosophy and poetry began when two working class men who were enamoured with philosophy because they'd done it quite late in life realised how useful it was and fruitful it was to help us live our lives. They decided to bring it down from the corridors of academe into the streets. Oh, by the way, I was a bricklayer, not a pipe fitter. Artist and pipe fitter, I was a bricklayer.
Yeah. Yeah. Engineer, actually.
I declared in my book, I think, that Arthur was president of the British Communist Party.
I was chair of the National Executive Committee, so
near enough.
So we came up with philosophy and pubs. The idea of philosophy and pubs was to try and remove the elitist perception of this thing that we realise is so important to us. And it's not just philosophy and pubs, it's philosophy and public. Not always good at the public. And the idea of being in a pub anyway is that it's in the heart of the working community. and the vehicle we realised was the group. And we got that from Sapri and Matthew Little and social action and everything that Graham's been saying. The community of inquiry, the group is very important, the way this education is done. And just one thing I want to say about. I used to be the secretary of Merseyside PIT, but it's grown, so now I've taken on this role of national coordinator and trying to be a bit more proactive and helping people who are in groups to try and start a group themselves. And it is working. I've been to London, Preston, Leicestershire, Manchester, and North Wales up to now, and it's starting to work brilliantly. So the important thing about PIS, which I want to point up, is its localism. The idea to try and create groups in a local area. So in Liverpool, and Arthur might speak more on that, in Merseyside we've got just on 16 groups now, and there's more in the pipeline. And the idea is that you set the group up and it has its own local legs and individuals. You know the problem with facilitation, they need more facilities. Well, the way we do it is, as soon as you start, we're asking people to facilitate, to learn from each other, and to facilitate it themselves while we're going on. And it goes off on its own, and the idea that it becomes part of the community culture to try and really affect society, that's what we're trying to do. and so that's the main thing. So it's starting to grow more and more, and I don't want to talk on too much about it because I'd rather get to the discussion phase and we can move on. Do you want to say anything about
that? Yeah, just on some of the interesting stats, as Paul said, we'll be setting our 16th up on Merseyside and hopefully we'll have maybe 20 at the end of next year. But we're not going out doing missionary work, saying you've got to have philosophy in your pub. It is very organic. We wait until people come to us and say, we want to start one in our local. And the qualitative change now is that we're actually getting pubs contacting us to say, we'd like to set one up. What they mean is, we'd like you to come in and set one up. When we get managers setting the group up themselves, we'll know we've cracked it. But the last counts we did, we had 320 or something like that people a month through PIPs on Merseyside. That's probably grown to near 350 or something like that because of the new groups. And as Paul said, what we do is we get people to do it all for themselves. We will parachute in and help them to get it going. But we actually have one guy saying to us, we don't want you to come because it gives us a false start. We don't want rent a mob. Because we can say to a dozen people, we'll get down to that pub and help to get it going. And sometimes we want that, sometimes we don't. So we do leave it up to the local organisers. And really what I think we're doing is developing, we could call ourselves organic intellectuals, I suppose, but more philosophical activists, I think, where people who are committed will do it. We're actually having people setting a group up in one pub, letting them get going, and then they'll go and set one up in another pub. So it's working like that. It is all member-led. And I think one of the interesting things and important thing is how eclectic it is. Because all the groups are different. The venues are all different. They're in pubs, cafes. We were holding one at the Tate Gallery for a while. And that really fizzled up because there was a total lack of support of the Tate. And some groups are more philosophical than others, obviously. Some have a different style of presentation to others. So we've got, although we'll have regulars going to different groups, and some of them go to two or three during the week, if they're real advocates. For a lot of people, it's hop on, hop off. And some people we'll see for a good while, and then we won't see them for a while, and then they'll come back. So you can dip into it. But what we do rely on it is, of course, enough people as the core membership of groups to, you know, so the people that turn up and there's somebody there. And it's quite strong for that. One of the things that's helped us is that we've organised the National Conference in Liverpool for the past 2 years, and we're organising next year's as well. Although we didn't want to, we wanted Brighton to do it, but we're doing it next year, and Brighton are doing it the year after. And that's been good publicity for us. And we're also running a lot of courses. Paul's doing an introduction to philosophy at the moment. We're getting in on the Superi facilitation course next year, which has saved us a job because we wanted the facilitators course next year. And Merseyside is the only, I'd have to say, is the only area that's big enough to have a committee. So we've got six proper committee members, and then a gang of other people turn up as well, because it's all open. And then across the country, most of the groups have got, most of the areas have got one or two operating, and that's up to that. But you know, we've got a framework at least. If you think you've got enough groups to start a committee, go ahead and start one. So it's quite healthy at the moment on Merseyside, and Paul's doing a lot of work around the country to develop our expansionist policy.
And brief initial thoughts about how you see your work developing or the general landscape developing?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? very happy with your report today. Research. Who was it?
Research.
That's fascinating. That's wide report you've done. It's a great starting point for us to start here tonight and move on and see what the situation is with things. We're just going to keep on doing what we're doing, and it seems to be working. And there is a mood anyway, in this movement or whatever it is that we're all involved in. And it's looking good, so I'm quite hopeful about it. That it's going to actually affect things. Because for me, although some of the organisations and the formal educational stuff you spoke about in your report is, as you've already said, stretching the meaning of philosophy, that might not cover that. And that's okay, because we don't want to be too precious at this stage. But we do realise that philosophical knowledge, philosophical understanding is the stuff that transforms and enables, it seems to me, the other knowledge that I'm biased. So yeah, it's looking good for me.